Yes.
Invited guests, media, ladies and gentlemen, you are once again welcome to the second edition of the Model ECOWAS Summit. This summit has become necessary, especially at this critical moment where peace and security within the sub-region is pivotal in every discussion and decision-making convocation. The Republic of Sierra Leone supports and will contribute to policies and reforms that will promote peace and security in the country and the ECOWAS sub-region. Mr. Chairman, the focus on the pride of Africans' heritage, culture, and tradition has indeed been at the center of African development. Nonetheless, the reverse of this cultural heritage and tradition has indeed, Nonetheless, the reverse of this cultural heritage and tradition has caused Africa, especially the Republic of Sierra Leone, to lose thousands and millions of lives and properties, respectively, in the 1991 to 2002 civil war, where most of these victims were women and children. Mr. Chairman, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, Sierra Leone is embarking on a progressive journey after a satisfactory policy implementation of the Agenda for Change and now running on the wheels of Agenda for Prosperity to becoming a middle-income country. This aims at gender equality, quality education, healthy population, good governance and rule of law, well-developed infrastructure, export-led growth generation, and wide employment opportunities. The progress of this agenda has ranked the country as the fastest growing nation in West Africa with annual growth rate of 20.1. Mr. Chairman, to bridge cultures to achieve peace and development, it is important to assess how flexible, responsive, and empowering state structures are with regards to their functionalities. And again, critically assess how open and considerate are the developmental policies and programs at the regional and national level to the diverse youth. Mr. Chairman, Sierra Leone requests the ECOWAS Commission to recognize, sponsor, and support this model ECOWAS Summit on the remit of Article 61 of Social Affairs of the ECOWAS Revised Treaty, which provides for the promotion of women, youth organizations, and professional associations as a means of ensuring mass involvement in the activities of the community. Mr. Chairman, to accelerate youth empowerment within the sub-region, Sierra Leone calls on the ECOWAS Commission, member states, civil societies to welcome the ratification of the African Youth Charter and to promote the awareness and implementation of the African Youth Decade Plan of Action. And again, establish and resource more youth and sports development centers as the ultimate means of bridging cultures to promote regional integration in member states, and also recognize and make her commitment towards achieving the UNAU Agenda 2030 and 2063, respectively, to create more opportunities and development on the continent. Mr. Chairman, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I call on the interparties involved in conflict in the Federal Republic of Nigeria, Mali, Burkina Faso, Cote d'Ivoire, and perhaps other member states who may have not experienced civil war to make peace and unity always prevail. I further entreat us all present to cultivate the habit of consistently tolerate peace in our respective countries. Peace is not a currency to be borrowed. I want to add this before I take my seat. Peace is not a currency to be borrowed from IMF. And so I entreat all of us to cultivate the habit of always ensuring peace in our communities. And I pray that by the end of this summit, we'll be able to present a communique that reflects our state and then make formidable projects for onward consideration of your state. Thank you.